send the deepest condolences to the family of Noram Faizal Mohamed Noor. Nama TV cameraman was killed in a firefight in Somalia, Mogadishu. Very sad and shocking. And I think many questions have been raised whether the most basic safety precautions have been taken for the journalists to take part in such mission. For instance, whether the most basic bulletproof vests were provided, whether Noor Faizal had been exposed to unnecessary risks, and whether the most basic measures, safety, security measures have been taken into account, or whether this was an avoidable death, which has caused so much sadness not only to the family but to all Malaysians, and that this should not have happened. Whether the mission that was sent by UMNO Putra was basically a mission to provide assistance or just a political stunt. I think there should be a full inquiry. Government should have a full inquiry to find out the actual circumstances into the killing of Bernama TV cameraman, because I think this is a concern not only for all journalists but for all Malaysians on the loss, especially if there's a loss of an unnecessary life, and which happening at this period of Hari Raya. In another 12 days, so the country will be celebrating the 48th Malaysia Day. I think a matter of great concern is that despite the Prime Minister's slogan of One Malaysia to bring all Malaysians together, since he became PM in April 2009, the country has not seen a greater escalation of the politics of race and religion, raising questions internationally as to what is happening in the country. In particular, the endless escalation of the race and religious stance. For instance, that the campaigns of Murtad of Christians to convert Muslims, that even the DAP has been accused of wanting to create a Christian Malaysia, wanting to have a Christian Prime Minister, which is completely baseless and without a foundation, but he became the subject of such so much mainstream media, Barisan control mainstream media exploitation, which undermine interracial and interreligious harmony and relations. And these are things that have been happening since we're working overtime in the last in the recent past. Hope the Prime Minister will use this Malaysia Day on September 16 to set an example, to get all political parties, whether in government or in opposition at all levels, to de-escalate, to arrest such polarization, and to reaffirm the primacy and importance of walking the talk of One Malaysia, not just the slogan One Malaysia, but there is the empty and hollow deep inside. On one hand, talking One Malaysia, on the other hand, you have the Deputy Prime Minister talking that he is a Malay first and Malay since second. Thirdly, on Wednesday, the Cabinet is meeting and we were told that they will be discussing on the question of the proposed Parliamentary Select Committee on the electoral reforms. I call on the Cabinet to take urgent notice of all the civil society responses. And undoubtedly, the question of credibility of the Parliamentary Select Committee on electoral reforms is the foremost question. You must be able to convince the people that the Parliamentary Select Committee, the proposed Parliamentary Select Committee on electoral reform, is a serious and genuine effort to ensure free and fair elections. And undoubtedly, the first thing you must do is to revoke the ban on Bersih. Bersih, by continuing the unreasonable and unjustified ban on Bersih too, I mean, it is speaking loud and clear that it is not, it's hard, it's not in it to bring about electoral reforms. And of course, the further there must be an assurance that the electoral reforms will be carried out as proposed by, as recommended by the Parliamentary Select Committee before the general elections, if there's going to be that public credibility. And but most important of all, the Elections Commission must be able to begin immediately to carry out the necessary electoral changes, which need not wait for the Parliamentary Select Committee. For instance, have a cleanup of the electoral roll, clean up the electoral register to ensure that only legitimate voters are on the roll, to ensure that all who are eligible to vote can be registered, to remove all the phantom and illegal voters. I think these are the basic requirements if there's going to be public confidence in the Parliamentary Select Committee. And I hope that the Prime Minister will also declare his commitment to the concept of a caretaker government when Parliament is dissolved, and that there will be no abuse of power in the misuse of public funds from dissolution. And there is no actual government already, there's only a caretaker government. There should not be abuse of power, go around distributing money, promising to distribute money, to set an example of seriousness to bring about free, fair, clean elections that can be respected locally and internationally. Maybe before you have any questions, you'll say something before I get a little bit.